Hello Generals, welcome in a new video. Today we are going to speak about the Special Forces and I am going to give you a tutorial how to use them properly in Conflict of Nations World War 3. But before that, we shall start with the top 5 Special Forces in the world. This choice have been after a lot of research and a lot of opinions in our Discord server as I consulted my members. They are international from all over the world, so every one of them has given me an opinion, and today we are going to give you what we came up with these opinions. So in the fifth position, I'm going to choose a Special Services group of Pakistan. Very brave and courageous, a Russian president once said that if he had Pakistan's army and Russian weapons, he would conquer all the world because they were very brave. I approve. The Pakistan Army Special Service Group, or SSG, is the Special Forces unit of the Pakistan Army. They are also known by their nickname of Maroon Berets due to their headgear. The curriculum of the basic military training course included the mastery in judo and karateka, special weapons training, military navigation and handling and disarming of the chemical explosives, survival skill training. In the fourth position, the Indian Marcos. The Marine Commandos, abbreviated to Marcos and officially called the Marine Commando Force, are the Special Forces unit of the Indian Navy and is responsible for conducting special operations. They were founded in February 1987. Marcos are capable of operating in all types of environments, at sea, in air and on land. They engaged in several operations since their creation. We can mention Operation Pawan 1987, Operation Cactus 1988, Operation Black Tornado in 2008, anti-piracy operations in the Gulf of Aden and the Indian Ocean were all successful with the full mark. In top 3 now, in the third position, we will go for the Russian Spetsnaz. The Special Operations Forces of the Armed Forces of the Russian Federation, commonly known as the Special Operations Forces, are strategic level special forces. It is also a structural and independent unit of the Armed Forces. The Spetsnaz training is driven in much of the same way as that of the British SIS or the American Delta Force, specialists in covert operations, sabotage, assassinations and reconnaissance. Having an estimated 15,000 Spetsnaz operatives all over the world, with a reputation as being one of the best special operations forces in the world, which is in part due to the very harsh Spetsnaz training resume each operative must go through. In the second place, we choose Special Air Services of the United Kingdom. The Special Air Service, SIS, is a special forces unit of the British Army. The SIS was founded in 1941 as a regiment and later reconstituted as a corps in 1950. The unit specializes in a number of roles, including counter-terrorism, hostage rescue, direct action, and covert reconnaissance. Much of the information about the SIS is highly classified, and the unit is not commanded on by either the British government or the Ministry of Defense due to the secrecy and sensitivity of its operations. The Special Air Service was a unit of the British Army during the World War II that was formed in July 1941 in North Africa by David Stirling and originally called L Detachment Special Air Service Brigade. The Special Air Service Regiment has been awarded the following battle honors: Northwest Europe, Tobruk in 1941, Benghazi raid, North Africa in 1940 and 43, landing in Sicily, Termoli, Valle di Comacchio, Italy between 1943 and 45, Greece 1944 and 45, Adriatic, Middle East, Falkland Islands, Western Iraq and the Gulf in 1991. In the first place now, we are going for the US Navy SEALs. The United States Navy Sea, Air and Land SEAL teams, commonly known as Navy SEALs, are the US Navy's primary special operatives force and or a component of the Naval Special Warfare Command. Among the SEALs, main functions are conducting small unit special operation missions in maritime, jungle, urban, arctic, mountainous and desert environments. SEALs are typically ordered to capture or to eliminate high-level targets or to gather intelligence behind enemy lines. Although not formally founded until 1962, the modern-day US Navy SEALs traced their roots to World War II. The United States military recognized the need for the covert reconnaissance of land beaches and coastal defenses. As a result, the Joint Army Marine Corps and Navy Amphibious Scout and Raider School was established in 1942 at Fort Pierce, Florida. The Scouts and Raiders are formed in September of that year, just 9 months after the attack on Pearl Harbor, from the Observer Group, a joint US Army Marine Navy unit. From the missions they carried, we can mention the Korean War, Vietnam War, Iraq-Iran War, Panama, Persian Gulf, Iraq War, Afghanistan, and the death of Osama bin Laden, Operation Inherent Resolve. Of course, we are not going to speak about the technology because the US Navy SEALs, they are the leading special forces in the world in the term of technology. They have the most advanced tech and intel they can provide from all of the agencies in the United States that can provide a very authentic and very direct intel. So I hope that our top 5 special forces in the world were satisfying for you guys. I know that everyone have his own opinion and he wants that the special forces of his own nation are the best, but we can mention also that there is the Polish Grom, they are very good. We can the SASR of Australia, they are also perfect, and there are a lot of other special forces that have the merit, they have the credits, and they did a lot of good operations for the humanity. So please guys, I'm eager to see your top 5 special forces in the comment section. Give me your opinion and I will give you my rating. Thank you so much. And now let's get to real business, as I am playing with the SASR of Australia, the Special Air Services Regiment. Afghanistan is the first one. He is a very huge threat to me and my allies, and now I have sent my special ops to infiltrate behind the enemy lines, and here we are using the scout ability of our special forces, and we can see that Afghanistan have infantry and have main battle tanks. Now it's the time to infiltrate his cities and kill everything he have. Of course, my special forces, they are stealth. He doesn't see me, he cannot see me, unless my units, they are engaging in battle. So here, those units, they are not going to be a problem for us because Afghanistan was not waiting for this infiltration. Yes, I declared war on him, but he doesn't know how or when and how I declared war on him. So he is trying to chase me, but he doesn't know where I am coming from. He literally nuked his capital, Kabul, because I had my special forces there. They were engaging his main battle tanks, but he literally didn't know what to do while my special forces, they are coming and going and he can't see them, he can't locate them. He literally nuked his capital. Look at the chaos, look at the mess we caused for Afghanistan. He is a tough enemy. He have a lot of max level strike fighters, by the way, but he could not use them because he can't locate my position. You know that strikers, they can attack anything on their way, but they cannot reveal stealth. So on their map, they will not see my special forces. And of course, here in the Australian Army, I made special forces, National Guards, to take lands and some ships. It's a combination of destroyers and frigates. And you can see here, the invasion was successful. And the infiltration was very authentic, it was very efficient. And the next target is going to be another huge enemy also, because after we destroyed Afghanistan, Sweden has taken the lead as he conquered all of Europe. And now it's the turn on Sweden to see the wrath of my special forces. And you can clearly see here the lands of Sweden. He is the first one and he is so far from us. We are afraid that he gets the solo win for himself. So this is why I dispatched my special forces for the action. And look what I found here in the airfield of Dnipro. All of his air force there is grounded for generating HP. He left them heal. He also have his infantry officer and infantries and 25 max level strikers with their air ace. Look at this fabulous prize which is waiting for me. You see here, I'm not in war with Sweden, and these special forces, they don't declare war when they are infiltrating behind the enemy lines. So this is another advantage of our special forces. Here I always try to avoid the centers of the cities when I infiltrate and when I dive deep in the lands of our enemies, because I don't want my special forces to meet any more hostile units and declare the war. So here, the special forces, the strength point of the special forces is the element of surprise, where you kill, infiltrate, carry on your mission and go outside without being detected, without being seen. This is the amazing thing about the special ops. And you will see in this video how we will be taking them enemy by enemy, one by one, and we are destroying all of their defenses, all of their armies and units. And now we shall see what will happen to this air force, what will happen to the infantry, elite infantry officer of Sweden with his max level infantries. You can know that we have the range, his infantries have the attack range, but they don't do anything. Why? Because he literally can't see my special ops coming for him. And here I'm using the disembarking feature for the special forces. You know that special forces, they don't require harbors to enter to the cities and lands. They can enter from any point in the map. Like literally, you can avoid entering from cities, you can avoid entering from hostile provinces and other cities. So like that, you will be always going all around your enemies from the behind enemy lines without being detected, and of course without meeting any more allies. And now it's the moment of the attack. What happened? The server is refreshing. Let's see what is going to happen here. I have two stacks of special ops, and in one single strike, everything is doomed. 25 max level strikers with their air ace, bye bye. And you can see here clearly, with the second we established the attack, the war is declared. But now Sweden, he can't see my special forces there in Dnipro. He will receive a notification that I destroyed all of his air force and destroyed his elite infantry officer, but he will not see my special ops. And more important, I need to move them, because he will receive notification that the attack has taken place in Dnipro, and he knows that I have been there. So after I take down my enemy, never stay in that city. Just move anywhere else so you cannot be detected. And what I am going to do here, the best suitable solution is to go straight for his homeland cities. But guys, never send your air force by sea. They will be not stealth when they are passing by the sea. And also don't do air assault also, because when air assaulting, you will not be stealth. So the perfect solution here is to go province by province from the land and avoid the cities. Don't pass far from the cities, because we don't know what they have in their cities. We need to scout first, because the good thing about the special ops is that when they are scouting, they give you the exact combination of the army existing in that city. So before approaching any city in the map, keep your special forces close to it, so you can be able to see the composition of armies and defenses there, and later it's your choice to attack or not. Now the Philippinian Navy has came for the support. I cleared all of Ukraine with my special ops, and now the city of Volgograd shall be released. Yes, it is. Now I'm going to send my airborne officer, who is the officer of my special ops. I'm going to send them straight to the Finnish lands. We can see here that Finland have based infantries and level 1 gunships. By the way, level 6 gunships, they can reveal stealth. I will speak about the units that can reveal our special ops. We can speak about drones. We can speak also about recon vehicles. And we can speak about level 6 helicopters gunships, not attack helicopters, helicopter gunships. And now we are stationed in the homeland cities of Sweden. You can see I kept some distance from the center of the cities to see what kind of defenses we have there. Looks like Sweden have made a turn of infantries, and they are ready. And now the Australian Special Air Services, they are going to destroy all of those infantries, the Swedish infantries there. Also, I have the Navy, because after all, when you have the special ops, your special ops will not be able to kill ships, hostile ships. They will not be able to destroy any navies. So a naval support and naval cover should be adequate, should be very good to escort your special ops and give them a safe passage through. And of course, the Navy is going to be very important here to help our special forces to be alive, because maybe like Sweden, he can have some max level gunships or drones, he can locate our special forces, but we know for a fact that he doesn't have that. But if he did that, we have the frigates, they can do that job. Now I'm deciding to turn back to Finland because looks like Sweden is not going to be a problem as I destroyed all of his air force there in Dnipro. I have this stack that is going to continue infiltrating to the capital Stockholm, but at the same time I'm going to send my airborne officer to the capital Helsinki. You see here the casualties. Sweden 48,000, Australia 9,000. You can see the gap of casualties there. And this is what we were speaking about. Like, Sweden have max level cruisers there in the capital Stockholm. This is why we need our navies. I did the option of attack, aggressive. This is why my destroyers, they engaged in combat before passing through the Finnish lands and to the Baltic Sea. My second stack of destroyers shall destroy those cruisers, of course. I'm going to attack. I'm going to use the strategy of hit and run because those max level cruisers there, it's going to take a while to take them down. And this is another prize for us. My choice to go for the capital Helsinki was a good choice as five heavy bombers, they are waiting for me there to be destroyed. Nice. I shall also clear the city in the north to destroy those gunships. I'm going to cripple all of their air force, and this is their third ally, Baltic States. Baltic States have a lot of armored divisions and mechanized infantries, but the good thing, all of his cities, they are coastal, so I will give that task for my task force to destroy them and bombard all of his coastal cities. And my special forces, they are going to continue destroying the air force of Finland and infiltrate all the last cities of Sweden. This is the airborne officer, dead. The gunships and the infantry, they are dead in one single strike. The offensive abilities of the special forces, they are tremendous. They are unbelievable. Like, seriously, you can't imagine 9 max level special forces with their airborne officer in the jungles. It's amazing. It's literally amazing. Like, seriously. Okay, so we destroyed those bombers also in one single strike. Helsinki has been freed. Let's go to Tampere. And later on, I will go inspect Turku. But first, like usual, I will not send my infantry straight to the center of the city. Before that, I will keep it in a distance a little bit to be able to scout and see what is it there. You can see here that there is one infantry in the city of Gothenburg, and it shall be destroyed also. In Tampere, here what he have, also one infantry and 2 gunships, that's nice, I will continue destroying them. So I literally destroyed Baltic States, Finland and Sweden without taking one single province, without one single infantry. But here, after the stage of the Scandinavian nations, we have another problem. Like the Africans, they jump straight to Europe to take their bounty. It's our bounty because we fought it, but they came straight to take our lands. But I didn't hesitate to declare war on Libya. And here I am sending a stack of frigates to the coastal cities of Libya, and they are detecting a lot of air force. And at the same time also, I prepared my special ops to go to the homeland cities of Libya. Look at this beautiful airborne officer there going to the city of El Jouf. We can see a max level striker and 2 level 5 main battle tanks, and he also have level 2 anti-missile. A very, very decent army, but this army is not going to be enough for my special ops as he have also naval recon aircrafts. Oh, it's going to be a huge prize here. I'm going to destroy him to ashes. Okay, I'm going to send the 2 stacks. So here the trick is to send 2 stacks at the same time, they shall attack in the same second. To be able to kill those main battle tanks in one single strike. We don't want to keep attacking because our special forces, they are going to be visible. They are not going to be stealth again. And if they are visible, they will be an easy target for them to be targeted with strikers or bombers. You understand? So that's how we destroy your enemy in one single strike and remain stealth. So here I'm going to make a small tutorial for you guys. I have this 9 max level special ops, and we have a heavy stack in the city of Örebro, Libyan stack, and I'm going to try the air assault. I'm going to show you how the air assault works. So first of all, 9 special ops in air assault, they are going to have an efficiency of 70%, because you know, in air assaults, in air force, everything, the max of the stack is only 5 units. So you can see here I made a huge mistake by sending 9 special ops in the air assault, and of course they lost a lot of efficiency. But the good thing here, when air assaulting your special ops, they will carry the first strike. You understand, in the second of contact, your special ops and the defending units, they will collide into each other. But in the air assault, your special ops, they will be the first ones to carry that assault. They will be the first one to give the damage for the defending units. You understand that? So this is what happens in the air assault. And I really wanted to show you how my airborne officer and those special forces, how they are very strong in jungles. Because now I already carried the mission to destroy the homeland cities of Cameroon. And I also dive deep after taking care of all of the homeland cities of Libya. I went down to his ally Cameroon, and he had a lot of SAMs, a lot of anti-missiles. So guys, I hope this tutorial was very beneficial for you. Guys, I hope you learned a few tricks here. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.